Today I got for you a surprise box unboxing with my brother-in-law here, Drew.
And the youngest child, the Spaz.
First we have Magic the Gathering Legacy Edition. How do you say that?
Chandra Nalar. This is actually my favorite planeswalker from the Magic set. That's really cool.
Well, Magic the Gathering Legacy Collection.
Johnny Goldmane.
The same line.
Nisa Ravain.
Dude, chill.
That's how it says.
Nisa Ravain. Ravain?
Yeah, I believe that's how it says.
Oh, by the way, these are from Funko. Love Funko. I love you, Funko.
Funko's awesome.
Funko, yeah! Alright, let's bust into these guys.
This goes against everything I know as a collector.
That's what these videos are for.
Okay.
All you collectors get mad, baby.
Why did you open that? You destroyed the full dollar value.
Oh, the cape is really adorable. What do you call that, plastic?
I don't know, plastic. Some sort of durable plastic.
It's floppy though. It's like a real cape. It's not like...
Yeah, it's not like hard plastic.
Yeah.
Well, I just popped her head off trying to get her out. So.
Is it brown? Well, we'll take Micah back home. Her head came off in the packaging.
Yeah, alright, well, this is what the head looks like.
That's still kind of cool.
I believe it pops back on. It looks like it does. It looks like you can take her pieces off to kind of pose her.
She's really poseable. She has some really cool body art. Really poseable from the waist. The
same plastic material on the cape is also on the skirt.
Yeah. Nice. The ankles, the knees are double jointed. Elbows are not double jointed.
Yeah, these are actually really poseable characters. You got, let's see, joinable. Even right there at the wrist, it's like bendable. You got at the elbow, at the knees, and at the ankles. So you can pose it in like a bajillion different ways.
Yeah. Dude, chill.
You want to be famous or what, Tal?
This one comes with a staff. I guess she's magical, a magic elf.
She's like a wood elf kind of thing. I don't know. Her whole thing is she's green character, so hers is all nature and all that.
Oh,
yeah,
cool.
I see. So obviously this one's fire, red players. This is, like I said before, my favorite planeswalker. She's a total. She's like your typical ginger, you know, just like badass attitude. Now, she's got this little fireball that comes with it. It doesn't like connect or anything, but I assume you turn her to kind of pose it like that. And then just kind of stick it in her hand and hope it sticks.
The water toy.
Which is cool, but it kind of sucks
the
for
the water, the water toy.
Okay, her wrist turns, and you place the fireball like so.
Yeah.
Oh. I don't know, her armor is very steampunky. You got the...
It looks like maybe...
Some sort of accelerant, maybe?
Yeah. Like she has some kind of gas inside of that tubing to help her flame up.
A freaking... Yeah, there you go, right there. Okay, yeah, so maybe this hand would be the one that holds the fireball. And this is like the taunting hand, like, come get some, bro. Her wrists also turn in 360 degrees. Yeah, there we go. Okay, very carefully holding the fireball. Basically what she looks like. Come at me, bro. I'll burn your eyebrows off.
Maybe they can be friends.
Hey, come over and watch a movie.
I can't right now.
You can't make the voice like a girl.
Controlled burning forest.
I want to gossip, talk about boys.
You want to open the last guy? This giant tiger looking guy?
That is the white planeswalker.
White's planeswalker.
Nobody likes white, though.
Yeah, except you.
I mean, I bought a white premium deck, but that's different.
It looked like there were actually six characters in this series. Oh, series one. Six characters.
Yeah, there's like so many planeswalkers, it's not even funny. I'm surprised we didn't see the Liliana. Dude, oh my god. Like, this is awesome, but if you have a cat, like, you're gonna lose that fireball all the time.
Yeah, you definitely. You can't put no peg holes. So make a stand with popsicle sticks or something.
Yeah, okay, yeah, it looks like the middle section is also jointed, so you can kind of lean it back and forth. That's cool. That's very cool.
Down. Bam! The last one here, buddy.
Johnny Primate.
I can't believe you got such a deal on these.
I want to see him.
Okay, you'll see him just a little bit. He has some kind of crazy axe thing, dude. And
they use it back in, you see it in all the Egyptian movies, you know?
Yeah, that's like the thing that Spock and Kirk were going after each other with.
It's like a...
Bling, bling.
I don't know the actual name. It's like a spear, but it's got like a crescent blade on it.
Yeah. Got a sword with it too.
Oh yeah.
That figure's heavy.
That's cool. Okay.
This mug is heavy.
This is a weapon. Like, you could throw this at something and hurt them. It's got a little... What? The same material as that plastic. It's like, it's almost rubber. Plastic. Scimitar.
She fell and her head came off.
Yeah, but I don't know. Let
me see that.
Super glue that on or something.
What?
I don't know. It's.
Oh. Okay.
If you jam it on there, it's kind of just like removable.
Yeah, this thing is not going to stay on.
I don't know if she's
Funko,
like.
Funko, what'd you do?
Interchangeable or something.
Interchangeable head of what?
They're going to blame me. They're going to be like, you handled it too rough.
No, there's no stress. No cracks. It's just.
Poor design.
That's
okay. Tiny little bit of super glue. Nobody wants her head to bob anyway. A little bit of super glue.
Yeah. Okay, so.
We already ruined the value by opening it anyway.
Maybe that's part of her her character. She just, her head comes floating off and she can shoot the firebolt and then the head.
I can confirm that that is not part of her character. I can't recall of any planeswalkers where their heads just straight fly off their shoulders. Okay, Funko really liked the feet on this one because they took the twist tie and wrapped it literally like 30 times. Okay, here we go.
Let's see, ages 14 and up. I can see that because these are not for him. Not for him.
Tail's made out of the same material as the cape and everything else.
This is all jiggly.
It's all floppy.
Look at that. That's cool.
This is... See if I can get his other arm out.
Does that cape come off?
If you pulled hard enough.
So it didn't come off. Not,
yeah, actually,
not
it looks something. Like it could come off, but I wouldn't want to risk it.
Oh, go with me. The sheath. You can put a sword in it.
Okay. Sword. Oh, very cool. Very cool. Like that, kind of hidden. Be like a sneak attack.
Yeah, so you think all he has is a big, big thing. When he throws it, they come at him.
Yeah,
no.
Exactly. He goes to cut your head off with this and drops it. He pulls a freaking scimitar out and cuts your other head off.
Dude.
It's very cool. This is actually pretty durable, pretty heavy compared to the other characters. I don't know if it's a Zymol or what. This is Blade. Whatever this is.
Now, is his head part of the body?
Now, yeah, his head actually doesn't come off like the other
ones. Is it turned on?
No, it's on there pretty sturdy, so I think they made it one solid piece.
That's not too bad, I mean...
Yeah, considering the other one just straight fell off.
Recap.
Ah!
Double jointed, like most in the animal kingdom. At the knees, again at the ankle.
She's good. Her head's not coming off.
I don't know, I must admit, they would do that. My favorite character, and they're just like, ha! Let's mess with this kid.
We love Funko, though. Still love you. Doesn't matter.
Yeah, don't stop making toys.
Because, I mean, they beat NECA. They beat NECA.
Okay, let's do this. We got one hand for the freaking spear thing, and then we got another one for the sword. I wonder if it's going to end open.
Maybe I can
just...
Look at those nails.
Yeah, he's got some killer nails over here. What is this guy? You know what? Maybe the sword is supposed to say sweet.
And he's got sort of like a Bill Clinton thumbs up there.
Yeah. Looks like he's seen some junk. He's got a scar over his eye. I don't know if you can see it over his massive weapon. He Yeah. And got a cat fight.
With the headless one. So overall, what do you think? All three of them.
I think this was a hell of a deal for the amount of money you spent. My only complaint is that her freaking head pops off. That shouldn't do that. But
and she doesn't hold her fireball either.
Yeah, maybe there should be some kind of peg in the bottom of the fireball and like a little peg in the hand, you know, kind of.
And no peg holes for the feet or stands.
This big sucker doesn't need pegs though. Like, no. I'm pretty sure he'll just stand on his own with his giant size 18 feet.
But the actual artwork, the paint job, the molding of these figures are stunning.
Yeah, spot on.
Beautiful one here.
The designs on all the armor, everything is, I mean, spot on from what I remember from the few cards I've seen of them. Doesn't look like there's any kind of blemishes or anything. I mean, down to the detail on the cape, you got all the little rivets and stuff. It's not just like a generic piece of plastic thrown over it. So, very cool, very good stuff. They took some time with this.
All right. Well, we appreciate you watching. Please give us a like, thumbs up, share, comment. Tell us what you think. Who's your favorite Planeswalker?
It's Chandra.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Say bye. Bye. Bye.